Did you know that two of North America's largest countries, the United States and Canada, are coming together for a project that will change the landscape of international travel and trade? Welcome to the story of the Gordie Howe International Bridge, a $6.4 billion investment that will redefine how goods and people move between these two nations. This bridge is more than just steel and concrete. It's a bridge to the future. The cities of Detroit, Michigan, and Windsor, Ontario have always held a unique place in North American history. Located just across the Detroit River from one another, they have been connected by more than just geography. In the 19th century, Windsor became a critical stop along the Underground Railroad, helping thousands of fugitive slaves find freedom. Meanwhile, Detroit grew from a small settlement to a bustling hub of commerce thanks to its strategic location in the Great Lakes region. By the early 20th century, Detroit was booming, largely due to the rise of Ford Motors and the automobile industry. From 1900 to 1930, Detroit's population grew from 285,000 to over 1.5 million, making it one of the fastest growing cities in the world. With this rapid growth and its strategic position along the Canadian border, international trade between Detroit and Windsor also flourished. But there was a problem. Nearly all transport across the river was done by ferries, slow, costly, and limited in capacity. This changed in 1910 with the opening of the Michigan Central Railway Tunnel, the first physical link between Detroit and Windsor. Less than 20 years later, the iconic Ambassador Bridge opened, providing a critical four-lane suspension bridge between the two cities. Over the following decades, these connections became the lifelines of trade and travel. Today, the Ambassador Bridge is the busiest international border crossing in North America, handling more than 4 million vehicles a year and accounting for a staggering 24% of all merchandise trade between the US and Canada. Yet, despite their historical significance, both the bridge and tunnel are showing their age, struggling with increasing congestion and inefficiencies. Vehicles crossing the border must navigate a complex and time-consuming route, dealing with slow traffic on city streets and outdated infrastructure. Recognizing the need for a more efficient and sustainable solution, the US and Canadian governments formed the Binational Transport Partnership in the early 2000s. After years of studies and discussions, the plan for a new bridge was approved.
But it wasn't without challenges.
One significant obstacle was opposition from Manuel Mati Morun, the billionaire owner of the Ambassador Bridge. Fearing the new bridge would end his monopoly, Morun launched a series of legal and public relations battles, spending millions to halt the project. For years, Morun fought against the construction of the Gordie Howe International Bridge. He funded advertisements and even proposed a second span for his bridge. But despite these efforts, the project moved forward, all thanks to the determination of both governments and the local communities who saw the potential benefits. Construction of the Gordie Howe International Bridge officially began on October 5th, 2018. Named after the legendary Canadian ice hockey player, the bridge represents more than just a new crossing.
It symbolizes a new era of cooperation and prosperity between the US and Canada. The bridge will span 2.5 kilometers across the Detroit River, making it the longest main span of any cable-stayed bridge in North America. Its design features two massive A-shaped towers inspired by hockey sticks, rising 220 meters, taller than the Golden Gate Bridge towers and over 70% of the height of the Eiffel Tower. With six lanes, three in each direction, and a dedicated pedestrian and bicycle lane, the Gordie Howe International Bridge is built for the future. It will connect directly to Michigan's I-75 and Ontario's Highway 401, creating a seamless link between the US and Canada. But this bridge isn't just about traffic and trade. It's about building a sustainable future. The bridge is designed to minimize its environmental impact with energy-efficient LEDs, green roofs, and the use of native, drought-resistant plants. It will also help cut vehicle emissions by reducing idling times at the border, benefiting the environment and improving air quality for the surrounding communities. The project will also have a tremendous economic and social impact. $23 million is being invested in community improvements, including parks, recreation facilities, and community centers on both sides of the border. The bridge is expected to create 2,500 jobs, offering new opportunities for local residents and businesses. Construction has been progressing rapidly. By July 2024, the main bridge structure was complete, with the final deck section placed in June of that year, uniting the US and Canadian sides. Now, work continues on paving, installing electrical and fire protection systems, and completing the ports of entry. Once open in the fall of 2025, the bridge will reduce border crossing times by 11 to 18 minutes, increase daily vehicle capacity, and provide redundancy in case of closures. It's built to withstand heavy usage and severe weather conditions, ensuring a reliable crossing for decades to come. The Gordie Howe International Bridge will stand as a testament to what can be achieved when two nations work together. It will be a symbol of unity, progress, and a brighter future for North America. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and click the bell icon to stay updated with more stories of innovation and progress